Hi everyone, and welcome to Wildix Collaboration video tutorials. Today we will talk about the first time access to Wildix Collaboration. Normally, users receive a welcome email with their login, password, the link to join Wildix Collaboration, and the link to download the smartphone apps. To be able to access Collaboration, you need at least an essential license. You can use Collaboration in the browser, no need to download or install anything for that. We recommend using HTTPS mode and Google Chrome browser. Type your email address or your extension into the field Login and your Wildix password into the field Password. Click Login. Otherwise, you have the option to use single sign-on via Google or Microsoft. In this case, you can use your Google or Microsoft credentials to log in. The first time you open Collaboration, you are prompted to provide access to your microphone, webcam, and location. You can change it later on in your browser settings. First of all, I recommend you to add colleagues to your roster. If we click on the colleagues icon in the top menu, we can only see the colleagues from our own department. To add other colleagues, click on the small arrow down icon next to Settings in the top menu. A drop-down list opens. Click on Edit Colleagues. In this dialog, we can see all the employees subdivided by their departments. Select or deselect people or entire departments and click Save. Now our roster is populated. We can choose to see all the users or separate departments. We can also hide offline users if we want to. For that, click on the arrow down icon and click Hide Offline Users. We can also see our colleagues on the geographical map if we click on Map View from the same drop-down list. From the Colleagues menu, you can start a conversation with any of your colleagues. Right-click on a user to start the chat, call, send a post-it, call me back, etc. Let's start a chat with one of our users. Once we double-click on a user, we find ourselves in the chat tab and we can start typing our message. From the same menu, we can start screen sharing with this user, send files, place a call, etc. All of our recent chats appear here in the left-hand section of the screen. Now let's add a user picture. Click on the arrow down button located in the right-hand corner of the screen in the top menu and click on Edit Picture. We can make a new picture using our webcam or pick out a photo from our PC. Resize it if needed and save. The green circle next to my user picture represents my current user status, available. From our Colleagues menu, we can easily see the present status of our colleagues. Red means do not disturb, yellow means away. Handset means that the user is talking on the phone or receiving a call. You can see more details about the user status, geolocation, status message, etc. if you hover the mouse over that user. Now let's see how you can set up your own status and status message. Click on your user status icon in the right-hand corner in the top menu. A drop-down list opens, allowing you to quickly change your status into DND or Away. Click on Advanced if you would like to specify the status message. For Do Not Disturb and Away statuses, you also have the option to set up the date and time when your status should go back to Available. In the top left-hand section of the screen, there is an input field. To place a call, type a phone number into this field and click on the green call button. Next to the call button, there is an option allowing us to select the device for calling. Web means that the call will be placed directly via the browser. Thanks to WebRTC, calls are natively supported by Wildix Collaboration. You can change the active device. Click on Web to view all of your available devices. You can also use the input field as a search field. Start typing a name of a contact or a colleague. Otherwise, click on the microphone icon to use the voice recognition option. All the matches found in the Share Corporate phone books appear in the drop-down list. Hover the mouse over the contact to view the available options, and click on one of the phone numbers to place a call. If you have any external audio device connected to your PC, such as a headset, you might want to first go and check whether the correct audio device is selected. For that, click on Settings in the top menu. Then select Web Phone in the left-hand panel. These are the settings for our web phone. You can select the microphone, the webcam, the speakers that you would like to use. And you can do an audio test to make sure everything works as expected. We have now started an outgoing call. Here in the right-hand part of the screen, there is a call dialog, allowing us to manage this call, put it on hold, hang up, transfer, etc. The same call dialog opens when you have an incoming call. Once the call is finished, we can see it in our call history. And finally, if you need to access some basic settings, such as language, click on Settings in the top menu. Click on Personal on the left panel. In this menu, you can change the language of the collaboration interface. The same language will be used for the audio prompts of the system if the corresponding sounds package is installed on your system. You can also specify the phone number for mobility extension here in the field Mobile. In the Settings menu of Collaboration, you can set up call forwarding rules, add the function keys for your desk phone, enable two-factor authentication, and push notifications. But we will talk about it in our next videos. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.